We are still at an undisclosed location in Las Vegas, Nevada, at one of a potential three security conferences that happens in late July. Probably gives you some idea where we are. Right now I'm with Joel Fulton. Joel, you are the relatively new CISO at Splunk.
I am.
I know that you're a pretty subtle, mellow guy, but let's see if we can drag some stray truth out of you. We talked a little bit about the current state of security in our industry. How do you feel about where we're going right now, what's happening?
I think that we have lost our way. I think that we don't do the things that would make us successful, and instead we repeat the things that make us personally successful.
Interesting. So profit in front of actually protecting people.
Personal career development, self-aggrandizement ahead of securing the entity.
Oh, wow.
For example, the lifespan of a CISO is like that of a blue bottle fly, about 18 months. So instead of committing to programs that eventually secure in a demonstrable way the organization, very much we are as a group centered on how can I do better in my career? What's my next position to jump to?
Interesting. So when you're with your peers, whether it's events like this one or smaller things, or even if it's just a buddy of yours and the topic comes up, how can you push for improvement without sounding like you're a crusader, without you're the one guy who's not in it for the money?
Yeah. So there's two approaches, right? One is chase tools, chase features, chase capabilities, chase the new thing in the Gartner upper right quadrant, right? The other approach, there was a presentation given by a director from the NSA. How do they break into systems? What works for them? We should pay attention to that, because what we do poorly at, patch our systems, identify our data, segment networks, classify data, apply controls correspondingly. We don't do that very well, but we buy the new box, we buy the new app, because it gets our name out there. It makes us look like we're active.
It makes us look like we're active, exactly. The appearance of activity, being busy, not necessarily doing good work.
Yeah.
Now, with this not really being a big product pitch, but Splunk, you guys got a lot of fingers in a lot of pies. I mean, it's hard not to route through Splunk, which puts you in an interesting position. What are some of the things that you feel that you guys can be doing in order to push the industry as a whole to get away from the personal improvement and really end the notion of competition among companies and focus all of us against the bad guys?
Yeah.
No pressure on you.
So perhaps we can't end competition, and maybe we ought not, but maybe we change that for which we're competing. So if you look at security through the NIST lens, the five phases, identify, protect, detect, respond, and recover, right? Those are not identically sequential phases. The exit aperture of each phase is the maximum aperture of the subsequent phase. In normal person language, if I can't identify it, I certainly can't protect it. If I'm not protecting it, I can't detect reliably what goes on. If I don't detect, I can't respond, etc. So an investment up front in identify pays dividends in the four subsequent phases. But what we actually do is we have inadequate CMDBs. We don't know the status of our data. We don't know the systems, but we spend a lot of money on protect. And now we've moved to that phase shift between detect and respond. The faster I can transit, the more I can close those issues with rapidity. But way over here in the boring category of identify is really the gold left to be mined.
I like that, the gold left to be mined in the boring area. Now, in the news, you can't get away from whether it's ransomware, breaches, nation state cyber attacks, all of these things, which is great for our industry from a bottom line perspective. Scary for the citizen. Looking to the present, short term, and the future, are you hopeful? Are you nervous? Or is it still the same as it has been for however long?
Yeah. So 20 years ago, we were as bad at our jobs as we are now. 20 years ago, you read about advanced patient threats. Red teams can get in anywhere. Systems aren't patched or identified. You can't quantify the results of a breach, right? Think about Clifford Stoll, Cuckoo's Egg. The estimates for the damage that resulted went from $1 million to $10 million. They couldn't get any more precise than that. We're not any better. So am I nervous or hopeful? I'm determined. I and others are going to change this by being more diligent, doing the hard work. A sports analogy, odd place for it, Vegas, right? Prize fights. Everybody in our industry wants to be in a title fight. Nobody wants to do push-ups.
Ah, interesting. Yeah, the grunt work up front.
Yeah.
When you said determined, it got me thinking. We've, as I said, we're at an undetermined show. Looking at the future from a personnel perspective, do you feel, you hear the media terms, things like there's a shortage of talent or there's more of a skills gap. Do we have the people without the training, or do we need more people because the knowledge base that we have is aging out? Where are we right now from a personnel perspective?
Well, how would you falsify that hypothesis? Like, let's invert it. Suppose the opposite's true. We've got too many people with too many skills. How would we prove that wrong? Well, you'd have to measure efficacy, right? And basics of troubleshooting, you change one variable at a time to isolate that variable's effect on the overall system. We are unable to isolate skills as a variable because I also don't patch my systems, speaking as an industry. I know that any customer or any security practitioner I meet with, when I ask them, are your networks segmented? They, well, no, of course they're not. Are your systems patched? Well, I've got 4,000 Windows 2000 servers because eventually we're moving into the cloud, and that eventually we're moving into the cloud has been for 7 years, right? So do we have a skills problem? I think we have a commitment problem, a persistence problem.
Interesting. So a lot of stuff going on this week. I know that you're a busy guy. For people that you've teased a lot of interesting ideas here, if they're looking for more information with what's going on with Splunk, where can they find that?
Well, you can follow us at Splunk on Twitter or at blogs.splunk.com.
And that's blogs with an S. And if you're looking for me, I'm the knucklehead guy, but I go find amazing people like Joel. I am at PacMat73 on Twitter. All kinds of good stuff to come. Stick around.